Aladdin and the Magic Lamp. Aladdin was an impoverished young boy in an Arabian town. He was recruited by a sorcerer who passed himself off as the brother of Aladdin's late father, Kasim. He promised Aladdin's mother to set up young Aladdin as a wealthy merchant. The sorcerer's real motive was to persuade young Aladdin to retrieve a wonderful oil lamp from a booby-trapped magic cave of wonder. After the sorcerer had attempted to double-cross him, Aladdin found himself trapped in the cave. Fortunately, Aladdin retained a magic ring lent to him by the sorcerer as protection. When he rubbed his hands in despair, he inadvertently rubbed the ring. A genie appeared. He took Aladdin home to his mother. Aladdin had the wonderful oil lamp with him. When his mother tried to clean it, a second genie, far more powerful, appeared. He was bound to do the bidding of the person holding the lamp. With the aid of the genie of the lamp, Aladdin became rich and powerful. He married Princess Badrul Badur, the emperor's daughter. The genie built Aladdin a wonderful palace, far more magnificent than that of the emperor himself. The sorcerer returned and was able to get his hands on the lamp by tricking Aladdin's wife, who was unaware of the importance of the lamp. He offered to exchange new lamps for old ones. He ordered the genie of the lamp to take the palace along with all its contents to his home in Maghrib. Fortunately, Aladdin retained the magic ring and was able to summon the less powerful genie. Although the genie of the ring couldn't directly undo any of the magic of the genie of the lamp, yet he was able to transport Aladdin to Maghreb. He helped Aladdin recover his wife and the lamp and kill the sorcerer. The sorcerer's more powerful and evil brother tried to destroy Aladdin for killing his brother. He disguised himself as an old woman known for her healing powers. Badrul Badur fell for his disguise and commanded the women to stay in her palace in case of any illnesses. Aladdin, with the one stroke of his sword, slew the impostor. Everyone lived happily thereafter. Aladdin eventually succeeded to his father-in-law's throne.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.